Los Angeles is a wonderful place to live. I think it might be a better place to write about.
He loved the city most at night. The night hid many of the sorrows. It silenced the city, yet brought deep undercurrents to the surface. It was in the dark slipstream that he believed he moved most freely, behind the cover of shadows. Like a rider in a limousine, he looked out, but no one looked in. There was a random feel to the dark, the quirkiness of chance played out in the blue neon night. So many ways to live and to die.
I've been really lucky that I've had a succession of detectives that are willing to help me, and in helping me, it's much more than, you know, this is how we do it, or this is the procedure, or this is the science, or whatever. You know, that, well, that's just important, but it's window dressing on character.
We had a deal. Either pay me or go with a public defender.
Another $5,000?
$10,000.
Oh. Ain't you gonna count it?
Just did.
And we talked to a lot of actors, and Titus was making a movie, and we didn't get together with him for a few months. And then when we did, it all kind of clicked right away. He came in and, you know, he did a part from the script, but what was more important is he sat with us and talked about what his take was on this character of Harry Bosch and what motivates him and what's inside him, and that was the moment. I'd always, you know, this is all new to me, but I was told someone will come in and you'll just know it, and that was the moment.
For the record, please state your full name and rank.
Hieronymus Bosch, Detective 3, LAPD Hollywood Division. So I don't believe there's a better world than this one.
Don't walk away. Jesus Christ, Harry!
My job is to, for lack of a better word, sell Harry Bosch to the reader. They gotta believe in Harry Bosch.
Who's that?
It's my daughter.
Hey, Maddie.
I'm all for you being in our lives, but not if it's Harry, the fun-loving dad, and me, the disciplinarian mom.
First time I've ever been accused of being fun-loving.
There are cops who work on cases, and cases who work on cops.
I've been trying to get hold of you.
Who is this?
I know who killed your mother.
And, you know, Harry Bosch is my guy.
I'm Detective Bosch, LAPD Hollywood Division. This is the work I do.
Well, he's a classic kind of lonely hero archetype, which, you know, in the vein of Philip Marlowe, and
right.
There's a simplicity to a character when he has such a strong moral code. Like, mm-hmm. We all want to be more like that. I think as men, we all want to be a little bit like Harry Bosch.
Next Grandmaster has created so many memorable characters. We needed two very memorable characters to make this presentation. New York Times bestselling and Edgar nominated authors Alafair Burke and Michael Koryta.
One of us is shyer than the other one. It is our honor tonight and such a pleasure to celebrate our friend, mentor, and giant of the crime fiction genre, Michael Connelly. With more than 40 best-selling, award-winning novels spanning a career across four decades and over 80 million books sold, Mike has immersed readers in a complete and compelling world, Michael Connelly's Los Angeles as only he can depict it. Harry Bosch, Mickey Haller, Renee Ballard, Jack McAvoy, everyone counts. Writing with the reporter's eye that earned him a spot on the shortlist for a Pulitzer Prize, he has become the gold standard for contemporary crime fiction.
There's so many people I want to thank. my great-grandmother got her first library card. No, we want to thank one person. Michael Connelly is writer of superhuman talent, superhuman work ethic, and superhuman decency. Humility and success are not always partners. This guy makes it look as if they are. He makes it seem effortless. There are so many people in this room who have benefited from him. And he never wants to talk about himself, so I know he kind of hates what this is going to make him do tonight. But Mike, truly, from the bottom of our hearts here, thank you for all that you've done, and congratulations.
Well, the good news is I hired a speechwriter for this. The bad news is she starts tomorrow. But so on the way down here, I asked GBT to write a speech for me, but I got my wife's name wrong, so I'm not gonna go down that road. But I'll try to make this brief so we can get to the final awards and maybe get to the bar. Thanks to the Mystery Writers of America. Thank you to Michael and Alafair. It's kind of amazing to be here. I actually don't know what to say. A long time ago, I was watching an award program, and a writer won, and all he said was, "I want to thank anyone who's ever kissed me or punched me." And I thought that was the best speech a writer could give, because, you know, metaphorically and realistically, you learn and take from the people who kiss you and punch you. And I'm lucky that I've been kissed more than I've been punched. And I've had a very amazing path through our genre and our business. And so I got to thank some people. There's too many people to thank, but I've found over the years that, you know, if you surround yourself with the right people, someone earlier said it takes a village. With me, it probably took like a Greyhound bus, like maybe 38 seats. And then you stay on the bus with those people. I mean, I've only been at one publisher my whole career, two editors who have worked as a team, Michael and Asha, and, you know, 37. Thanks for giving me credit for 40 books, but 37 for 37 times. I've sent a manuscript into the maw of publishing, and they've come out better. And you just can't beat that. And I've had one agent, Philip Spitzer, one manager, Heather Rizzo, one person who's taken care of, who is way ahead of me on the curve of electronic and technology, takes care of all my social media, Jane Davis. They've just been with me for decades, and it's all been to my benefit, so I have to thank them. I've only had one French translator, and he flew here from Paris to be here tonight, and that's amazing. I fired him once, but it didn't get translated, and he's still working with me for some reason. But last but not least, my wife. We've all been in this position. We want to be writers. We got to figure out how to do it. We start as readers, and it takes some time, more time for some of us than others. And right now, it's probably not a bad time to be my wife. But, you know, 40 years ago, when I had this idea about being a writer, my wife Linda was she took on that dream that I did, and it was a long time, you know. A couple of unpublished books, and many years went by before I was actually holding a finished book. And but she was with me all the time. So this we share this, and just want to say thank you to the Mystery Writers of America again, and the people who put me up for this. It's an amazing honor, and I cherish it. Thank you.
Oh, nice.